Hi, my name is Jeff Shapiro, and I'd like to welcome you to the second Arduino Learning Board video. In the first video, I introduced you to the Arduino platform and the Arduino Learning Board project. In this video, I'll start by explaining each part of the Learning Board, and then we'll walk through creating an account on the CodeBender website, and finally we'll connect the Learning Board and download our very first program. Let's start by looking at the Arduino Learning Board. Here is a photo of the Learning Board, but since it's difficult to photograph the actual board in such a way to clearly show all of the parts and all of the labels on the board, I've created a graphical representation of the board that I'll be using throughout the videos. As we learned in the prior video, all Arduino modules share common types of pins, including voltage inputs, voltage outputs, digital inputs and outputs, and analog inputs. The Arduino Learning Board holds an Arduino Nano and brings each signal from the pins of the Nano to headers or sockets along the top and bottom of the board. These sockets are where we will connect jumper wires to use these signals in our projects. I've also grouped and organized the signals to place all of the digital inputs and outputs along the top of the board, the analog inputs along the bottom of the board, and duplicated power, ground, and reset signals on both sides of the board for easy access. As well as providing easy access to all of the Nano signals, the Learning Board also adds a red LED, a green LED, two push-button switches, and a 400-point solderless breadboard. Since I mentioned the solderless breadboard, which some of you may not be familiar with, let me take a few minutes and explain what a solderless breadboard is and how it's used. In any circuit, each component or part is connected to one or more other components or parts. While you could simply touch two things together, or hold them together with tape, or even twist them together, none of those methods are ideal for prototyping circuits. In a breadboard, each hole you see is a socket and is ready to accept and hold on to wires or component leads that you insert into them. What makes the breadboard work so well is that groups of holes are connected to each other underneath the board. In the center section of the breadboard, each vertical strip of five sockets are connected together. So if you place a wire in one hole and another wire or component in another hole, in the same vertical set of five holes, they become electrically connected to each other. In this example, a wire is inserted into one hole, and one side of a resistor is inserted into a second position in the same vertical set of five holes. Because both parts are inserted in the same vertical block, they become electrically connected together. Similarly, this second wire is inserted in the same block as the right side of the resistor and becomes electrically connected to that side of the resistor. Now that we understand how each vertical set of five sockets are connected, let's take a look at how the four horizontal rows of sockets are connected. These two are grouped in segments of five, but rather than each five being connected, the entire row is connected. These top two rows and bottom two rows are typically used for power and ground signals. In practice, you often connect the top red row to your 5-volt power and the second blue row to ground. This gives you lots of available places to grab power and ground signals when wiring your circuits. Once we get into building our first circuits, this should become much clearer. On the right side of the Learning Board, you'll find two LEDs and two push-button switches. Each LED and switch has a 2-pin header associated with it. To use the LEDs, you simply connect the lower pin to ground and the positive pin to a digital output. Setting the output to a logic high, or 5 volts, will turn on the LED, and setting the output to a logic low, or ground, will turn off the LED. You'll get to experiment with the LEDs and switches in the next video. In this course, we'll be using CodeBender for all of our programming. CodeBender is an online code editor for Arduino. It's cloud-based, which means you can start a project on one computer and pick up where you left off on another computer. Think of it as Google Docs for Arduino programming. And because it runs in your web browser, there's no complicated software to install or upgrade, and you have easy access to hundreds of libraries and thousands of examples. But before you can plug in your learning board, you first need to create a free CodeBender account. Let's take a look at the process. Start by opening a web browser and navigating to codebender.cc. CodeBender supports both Chrome and Firefox on Windows, Mac, and Linux, and Chrome OS on Chromebooks. I prefer the Google Chrome browser, so that's what I'll be showing here. From the CodeBender website, click Register in the upper right corner to begin the new user registration process. To create your CodeBender account, select and enter a username, email address, and password. CodeBender will let you know right away if your desired username is available. After entering all of your account information, click Register to continue. The next screen tells you that an email has been sent to the email address you used while registering. This is an extra step CodeBender uses to confirm the accuracy of your account request. Once the email CodeBender sent arrives, open the message and click Confirm Account to continue. Your account has now been created and activated. CodeBender will now walk you through their Getting Started procedure. Click Get Me There to continue. The Getting Started process consists of 5 steps. To continue the process, click Let's Go. This step will install the CodeBender app into the Chrome browser. Just click the blue Add It to Chrome to start. Just follow the instructions and the app will be installed. The next step is to install drivers for the Arduino boards. Click Download Drivers and follow the instructions on the screen to complete the driver installation. While the drivers are being installed, you may see this screen from CodeBender. After the drivers are installed, CodeBender will automatically move to the next step. From the board selection list, select Arduino Nano with ATmega328, since that's the processor used on our Arduino learning board. At this point, CodeBender is waiting for you to connect your Arduino learning board to your computer. Attach one end of the mini USB cable to your learning board and the other end to your computer. As soon as the device is connected and recognized, the serial port box will populate. Select the appropriate serial port and click Run on Arduino. While the program downloads, you'll notice the small RX and TX LEDs blinking, indicating serial port activity. And then, in just a few seconds, you should see the LED marked with an L start blinking. Congratulations! You've just successfully connected your Arduino learning board to your computer and downloaded your first program. In the next video, you'll see how to find and copy sample programs from the Arduino learning board account I've created on CodeBender into your personal account and download them to your board.